Securities markets have demonstrated impressive advances, accompanied by equally impressive activity throughout much of this year, in spite of countless uncertainties surrounding our political, economic, and international outlook. In tonight's business report, Bruce Jamison takes a closer look at what this may be telling us about the months ahead.
It has long been held that the market acts as a barometer in discounting or forecasting future events. As such, no less than five separate market indices have gone on to hit new all-time highs during the month of October. They have, however, been accompanied by more divergences than we have seen in the marketplace since very early in the advance, which began in March. Certainly from an economic point of view, signs of an upswing are numerous and unmistakable. Consumer spending and housing seem to have clearly come back to life again.
I would anticipate a modest recovery in 1981, and during the fourth quarter I look for the economy to cool. The coming economic expansion expected for the coming year is not likely to be as vigorous to past post-war periods. The consumer spending, for example, is not likely to be as vigorous as the case has been in the past.
Politically, any uncertainties or anxieties that any of us have are about to be dispelled within the next week and a half. Will the market reassessment of the situation at that time, or is it already discounted in the current price level?
We are going to have a muddying effect. I would say a great deal of it has somewhat been discounted, but should there be surprises in the election, should the international situation muddy up, it's very difficult to tab. I would say that during the coming months that there will be some uncertainty, some reassessing, and probably towards the end of the year we'll begin to regroup and look at 1981. Well, I'll look for the Iran-Iraq situation to have a minimal effect on the market. We've faced a situation in the past. This is not too uncommon to the situation we had during the Iranian Revolution. The advantage that we have during this period is that we have an adequate oil supply, and high oil prices cut down on demand for us. However, should the crisis continue for another 6 months, I would anticipate that oil prices could possibly rise as much as 35%, therefore having a negative effect on the economy.
If the advances to date in the market were telegraphing a short economic recession, the message appears to have been correct. If the increasing signs of selectivity and market divergence appear to be telling us something else, it may be that the economic expansion next year may be less vigorous than in prior recoveries. Until we're clear on the signals, neither the economy nor the markets appear to want to commit themselves. This is Bruce Jamison.